we created this idea called Moody Mocap so that the motion capture felt like theater. You know, it had lighting and it had sets and color, and it gave Steven and Mark and Ruby the ability to all kind of work together and forget about the technology and just think about the performances and for Steven to craft the film. So for us, that was the most rewarding part of it, because it was all in the moment. And then we took all those moments that Steven gave to us and just worked with him to help craft each shot into the film. And under the water was a really tricky one, because it's a little girl under this whole waterfall, but it was really nice to make that work, because you see in that moment the relationship between BFG and Sophie starting to develop. It's the first time that you understand that he may care for her. And that's kind of a key moment in the film. So I'm glad that it worked out.
Yeah, I think that's very true. I think, both the Queen and Sophie are probably, arguably the two strongest characters in the piece. So it's terrific. As the father of a 10-year-old daughter, it's terrific to see young women being portrayed in that light. And you're right, yes, all the men are largely slovenly, oafish brutes. Yeah, I mean, Roald Dahl certainly, carries that British sensibility with him. And it's certainly, a love letter to the kind of values that, he shows throughout all his novels, which I suppose is a certain Britishness to that. But I think the universal values, absolutely, as you said. I mean, again, it's love over hate, it's good over bad, it's, and hate never wins, which has to be a good thing.
It was a really amazing experience, actually. Just we had some great times of being able to rehearse these characters beforehand, get to know each other, all the actors as well, and kind of create a bit of a community within these giants and get those relationships going. And I think it really comes out on film. A brilliant, brilliant director with an amazing vision. And he knows what he's got and he knows what he wants. And I'm very honored to be a part of that.
I think it's interesting. I mean, I've never done motion capture before, but as I understand it, I mean, it's my performance and then there's stuff added to it, so I want to take part at least for some part of the credit. So like, let's say 75 me, 25, I don't know. I have no idea.
It's hilarious. It's a pretty funny thing to do, that he's everywhere, that he's like flying a helicopter at one point, building stuff. Yeah, it's pretty cool. He's kind of a Superman butler. I think that's interesting for the audience, that you go from this magical, mythical world into something which is, in a way, a magical, mythical world, that of Buckingham Palace. You know, like, that's in my city, Buckingham Palace. I'm from London and like, I see it all the time, but no one knows what goes on in there. And there is an archness and a campness and a sort of wonder to it that I think he's done a good job at painting a picture of.
Yes, but I played her completely straight, the Queen. I tried to be as like the Queen as possible. I had my gloves made by the Queen's glove maker. I had my hats made. I had my shoes made. I had my bag made. All from the places that she has her things made. That's what the designer did. Yes. Oh, yes. And she wore very bright colours. So she always does. So she can be seen in a crowd and at a distance. Because if people go out to see the Queen, she's only this high. And if they don't see her, it's a terrible disappointment. So she always wears very bright colours so people can come away saying, I've seen the Queen.